Hi, I'm Troy Hudson from Fonterra Food Services. What you're going to see over the next few minutes is the Proud to be a Chef program. It's been created by Fonterra as a launch pad for young chefs. We've brought together some of the finest chefs from around Australia and around the world to instruct, to mentor, and hopefully to inspire 30 of the best apprentices in this country. And please bear in mind, next time, this could be you.
I'm one of the creative directors of the Melbourne Food and Wine Festival. I'm also a trained chef. This opportunity of going to London for a whole month is just absolutely incredible. I also saw Philippe Howard today. He is an amazing chef. Have you got this? Look, what treasure trove.
There's such a wide variety of them. The different flavours that they have compared to normal European vegetables, it's unbelievable. Such a variety of vegetables you can be using to get that little bit difference in your dish compared to the next person down the road.
Being a country whereby we seem to be absorbing so many of the various styles that are coming from different parts of the world, particularly our proximity to Asia, you naturally would see quite a lot of the Asian produce, particularly the greens.
I'm going to demonstrate a couple of things and then I'm going to get you to go do them and then I'm going to get you to come back. So rather than just be a big maestro cooking session, then you go away, do it. We're going to do it in chunks. I don't know if it's going to work that way, but that's what we're going to do. I just feel like it's like my specialised subject is being bleeding obvious that you need to train young people well, and it'll put better value back into my business and also it'll embolden them for their future. 3 out of 4 apprentices do not complete their first year. It's probably 10% technical skills cooking. The large part of it is confidence and zeal, having a real fervour for your craft. I love my job. I love the diversity of it, you know. I wouldn't want to be sitting in meetings all day. I wouldn't want to be cooking necessarily all day. I wouldn't want to be designing menus all day or doing off-site functions or talking on the television all day.
Consistency is the most important thing. Ensuring, you know, it doesn't matter what I want to achieve or what, I can only do what goes on inside my head if I've got a great brigade in the kitchen. And I can't cook for 100 people 7 days a week, it's not going to work. So the absolute key thing is to make sure that you're recruiting the right people, training them, looking after them, motivating them, and just creating an environment that they want to stay put in. The critical thing as a chef is to make sure you're cooking food that people want to eat.
You need to have ambience, you need to have the beverage package, you need to have the front of house service. So, and I think that the general public, they demand these things now. It's definitely expected that it's a tidy package right from the beverage straight through to the kitchen.
Learned so much about produce and wine, and so we had different masterclasses with chefs as well, which we learnt a lot. So in particular about wine, I had no idea before, so now I kind of understand a bit more about matching with different foods and what sort of wines go with foods.
What's inspired me most is the passion behind it all, the chefs and how they've maintained their passion and how they keep looking for new things and actually try to push their own boundaries all the time. That's been really inspiring.
It doesn't matter when you discover your passion for food. It might happen to happen sort of relatively late, I suppose. You know, I went to university and I did a degree in microbiology. I found it fascinating. It was an amazing subject, very topical in the world today. But it just wasn't the thing for me. It didn't. I could see there was no. I didn't have any belief in it as a career, so to speak. But it was while I was a student I had to start cooking around to eat. My mum wasn't there anymore. And it was one of the things from absolute day one, I knew that's what it was going to be. You know, I found something that just I loved.
When you go to some fish markets, there's a lot of mass-produced filleting in that, which is, they call it wet filleting, where it's just sitting around in water. When it's sat there, it's obviously just absorbing a lot of water, it's destroying a lot of fish, especially if you're using like just semi-grade seafood and you're eating it raw. It really does change the characteristics of a fish. So we try and dry fillet, so keep it away from the water as much as we can. When you're actually at the market, if it doesn't have that nice thick slime on there, then it just means that it's all dried and it's been out of its natural environment for a longer period of time. So straight away you can tell the age of the fish is a little bit further down the track than what you want.
We're doing a butternut pumpkin soup, which is going to involve using a little bit of liquid nitrogen. Something we do at the restaurant, sometimes we play on words. We say it's a pumpkin soup, they think it's a pumpkin soup, but when they get it, it's something totally different. You know, it's unique to the restaurant. Next is going to be my interpretation of an English breakfast, okay? But it's just called the 62 degree egg. If it's cracking, just keep going, keep going. The key is getting it done before it melts. Come on. Come on, guys, you're running out of time. Pressure's on, pressure's on. Singapore's got a really, really interesting food scene. It's got some amazing fine dine restaurants. And it's also got amazing street food. Like, and the ingredients in Singapore is just outstanding. I've never seen a live barramundi come to a restaurant in Australia. Yet I get live barramundi delivered to my restaurant. You know, five, six kilo barramundis and they're live.
Fonterra always has a choice of where we invest, but it's incredible the response you get from investing in the development of chefs. So without question, this is a fundamental platform. We'll continue to invest in the development of chefs, and Proud to be a Chef is going to be a signature event, and Fonterra will be associated with that for a long time.
The whole experience in whole from Fonterra was fantastic. They've taken me from a city where I'm sort of a bit bored and taken me to a new place. I've never been to Melbourne. And it's shown me all sorts of different things, new experience, new culture in Melbourne.
The last week, I've been sitting on my computer, just researching every chef, reading every menu, especially Philippe Mouchel's, the Squares menu.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
That's great.
So there's our winner on his way to London, with a chance to work under the great Philip Howard at the world-renowned restaurant, The Square. Just think what a chance like this could do for your career. If you'd like to be part of the Proud to Be a Chef program, visit the Fonterra Food Services website at www.fonterrafoodservices.com.au.